appointment, dog.
That is strange.
Oh, okay. Broke the wire.
Well, there's a first for me. A bird nested right inside the entrance to the umbilical, so we'll pull it back out.
Whoa. What the hell was that? Did it again. Snapped it off right there. All right, try now.
So you're at the inside as well?
Yep.
It looks very shiny and nice.
Oh, thank you.
Perhaps it sank solid, and when it was crushed in, it took its shape.
You did it for
the world. Yeah. Looks like a fan belt of a car, doesn't it?
Yeah, but I think you're right. I think it's only tough from age. I think it was much softer than this, because this is just insanely too hard.
And being salvaged like, from underneath the ocean or something, probably yeah. Got salted as well, didn't it?
Yeah. Right, we'll keep this one and see if I can find that.
Thank you.
Yeah, everybody's worried about the dog. I think the dog's smarter than most of us. Oh, that's beautiful. Oh my God, I feel cool air coming in. Jesus, that's almost sit.
Yar!
Can you, I can hold this up and you can see where to grind it.
Okay.
You got a grinder out there?
I think that's what this one.
What are you not cut? A companionway cover.
Okay.
It's still on the opening. Yeah. Lift it up. It's not on the rails or anything. And just move it to this side so that it's open. We get a little airflow.
Yeah.
That's right. That doesn't feel like computer engineering class, does it?
Yeah.
There will be in the morning.
Okay. Clear, clear, clear.
Let's put another clamp right here just to pull these a little bit more in alignment. You got another one down there, in there? Just yank an F clamp off something. What's wrong to you?
The top hole is a few degrees off the top.
Oh. I can't see that.
Yeah.
Okay, do you want to put it? Let's get a level.
Yeah.
Right there. Lots of ventilation. Well done. A completely new look for us, and I like it. We got 4 frames to put in tomorrow, but all 10 holes are cut. We got the ceilings the right height. Just finished. Look at that. Number 3. It's gorgeous. That's class, isn't it? Look at that. He's going to church this morning and he is decked out to the nines.
Oh, it's lovely.
Well, the paint's still wet, but it's drying out a lot better than I thought it would. My brush marks finally went away. Gonna need some sanding and more coats of paint. What this is it's called a match plate, and it's a great way for doing castings. We've never tried it before, so I wanted to give it a shot. And we're gonna be able to make a bunch of cleats for the boat. These will be bronze, and we're gonna weld them around at different locations to tie off lines to. And you can see how it works is you have a cope and drag that's kind of normal. The only thing different about the cope and drag is it's got alignment tabs that let it slide all the way down a long way. So the pattern goes in there to start with, and you put sand on both sides of the pattern. We're going to use sodium silica sand, I can guarantee you that, because I don't mess with green sand. But then, so you pack your sand in there, then you split the mold, you take the pattern out, put it back together, and you're ready to go with the casting. So we really appreciate Peter and Morgan's work for that. And if you want to have a part in building our boat, it is the boat, the internet built. We actually have a t-shirt that says that, and we mean it. The best thing to do is go to our website, svseeker.com, and we have a blog there that'll tell you what's coming up. We need your input actually before we do things most of the time. That's helpful. And then we have a store that you can buy our junk from, and it's overpriced, so you know, don't go wild with it. But if you want that inspirational stuff sitting around, it's there for you, and it helps fund the boat. And we also started this scholarship fund, because the way we're going to operate this boat, I think we can do it for free. I think we can run this boat and have grad students and citizen scientists with great ideas and equipment that need to get out onto the water, and we can do that by letting you guys have a part in paying for the diesel and the fuel. And maybe we can go out to the Gulf, you know, one of the first things to do, and find out where some of that British petroleum oil went to and how it's still impacting the environment. Maybe we can do some wreck hunting. You know, the world is an oyster, it's for our taking. And if you can't come down here and help us work on the boat in person, then maybe you'll enjoy doing that. Anyway, we appreciate you watching. That's enough. Y'all take care.